you. Thank you, Paul. Before we bring out Lily Tomlin, of course, it's time to cross off another few days on our Phil Donahue calendar. Phil is moving his show from Chicago, Illinois, to this building right here. Do we know what studio he'll be in? 3-something, isn't it? 3G? 8G, okay. So we can cross off Friday and then also Saturday. Oh, this is fun. We get 3-4 big days and then... All right, now he's coming the 1st of November. So you want to make these at home and you can have the fun of crossing them off with us. We'll look forward to having Phil in the building. I had a good weekend. I had a really good weekend, and I'm well rested, as you ought to be. I cleaned out my garage, which was a lot of fun, and I'm ready to go now.
Ready
you had a good
go.
Weekend. You worked downtown.
Worked downtown.
All right.
Hippest room in the world.
All right.
The street, as you know.
That's right. Okay, we're all set.
You know what the word is out there, too.
Oh, do we have a word now?
Well, no, that was the word. I don't want to repeat it. I don't know why.
Okay, my first guest tonight is co-starring with Steve Martin in a brand new film called All of Me, which I saw this morning. I got up very early and saw this film. She is easily one of the funniest women working today. It's a pleasure to welcome back to this program, Lily Tomlin.
Hi, Lily. How are you? Nice to see you.
Pretty nice, isn't it?
Sounded good, but what was that man doing like this for?
No, he's
I had to get them to stop, I guess.
Sure, he doesn't want them rushing the stage. I saw All of Me this morning. I really enjoyed it. I thought you were very funny, and I thought Steve was very funny.
He was very funny, wasn't he?
Well, it's you were funny also.
Well, I'm sort of funny, but he's quite funny.
Well, geez, I don't know. I thought he was sort of funny, and you were quite funny. Tell folks what, it's not even out yet. When is it going to be released?
It'll be out the 21st. It's being released, and it's been going real well. You know, people have been responding quite positively to it, so that's like a load off a person's, future. Anyway, it's about I'm a very rich woman, in fact, a profoundly rich woman, and I've had a bad heart all my life, and I...
I've enjoyed having a bad heart all your life, too, right?
Well, I haven't enjoyed it that much. I mean, I've enjoyed it just because I'm arrogant and spoiled and indulgent, and I can, you know, knock people around a bit. But I do that because, you know, I've been quite deprived.
Yeah.
in a life sense, I've been deprived. Mm-hmm. And because I'm more or less, I'm bedridden to a certain extent. And, so I've arranged because, I mean, the height of indulgence is to think you can buy another human body. And so I arranged to have my soul transmigrated into my stableman's daughter's body.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, Steve is my lawyer, and he doesn't like me because I'm so arrogant and spoiled. And at the last minute, there's an accident as I'm dying, and my soul goes into his body. And I control the right side of his body, and he controls the left side.
Yeah. Then the fun begins.
And then the fun begins, yeah. Right. Yeah.
Transmigration now does that happen much?
Well, let's see. There's been transplantation with Ray Milland and Rosie Grier.
Oh, that's right. That's what was it? The thing with two heads? Is that what?
Yes.
That was? Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think there's ever been. There's been people ghosts have lived and spoken as in Topper. And then there's been kind of supernatural connections, as in, like, Heaven Can Wait.
Yeah, but I don't mean necessarily in the entertainment world.
I'm just trying to show how we've sort of, like, encompassed all these themes in this one vehicle.
So
we've got a little Tootsie in there, you know?
Yeah, a little bit, sure.
Yeah.
So you're a very wealthy... matronly kind of woman, although certainly not
too
old.
Matronly,
not old, no.
Pretty attractive.
Oh, yeah, a honey. No getting around it. A bedridden honey. And
are you going to show a clip? Is that what you're doing, or are you just chatting with me? You're just chatting right now, right?
Just chatting right
now.
Okay. What, do you want to show the clip now?
No, not at all.
All right.
I'm sorry. I thought I was missing out on... I thought I wasn't understanding.
I was just going to say, is this a part you can research, that of a wealthy, wealthy, wealthy person?
Well, it's hard. It is hard to research the profoundly wealthy because they do keep to themselves. They don't want to, you know, they don't go around with like the riffraff or anything. Mm-hmm. But I was lucky enough to, not in conjunction, it just came in handy. I wasn't researching this role at the time. I was just sort of researching. I wanted to do a very, very rich woman, and I happened to be someplace where some sort of rich people congregate.
Where was that?
It was a spa.
And, no, where was the spa?
Oh, just, I can't tell the spa just, because the person will know I'm talking about it.
No, but just geographically, where was it?
In California.
California. Southern California? No, but was it down by San Diego?
This is a more cultured kind of spa than the one to which you refer.
Up by Barstow. Okay, that's all right. It's all right.
I met a woman there who was a profoundly rich woman. In fact, I had a friend there, a girlfriend, who was also at the spa, who is a rich woman herself. And I'm not a rich woman at all.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, just very mediocre in the like, cash department.
Really?
Well, I mean, better than I was, say, in 1962.
Yeah.
But anyway, I had a very rich girlfriend there just by coincidence, and she told me that this other woman, this profoundly rich woman, was the richest person she'd ever met.
Oh, so that really is rich. Did you meet that woman?
And I got quite friendly with her. She was very, had a lot of humor about herself.
Oh, really? Like what?
Well, I said to her, I finally got to talking to her, and I said, well, you know, I'm working on a very rich woman character, and you've got to tell me what very rich people do I said, first of all, I need to know what they do for small talk, because I would never have the opportunity to have, you know, small talk with a profoundly rich person. And so she said, well, we talk about jewelry catalogs. And she said, Christie's, there's Christie's and there's Sotheby's. And she said, Christie's characterizes their jewelry as important, very important, and highly important. And that Sotheby's does not editorialize. Uh-huh. But she said this not without humor, but sort of seriously, too.
Yeah.
And she had a few, like, catalogs in her tote bag. But here's the best part. So I said to her, I said, well, you know, it must be very difficult, especially when you're a young person growing up, perhaps in college and such, to know who you're socializing with. You know, you have to be very careful. And she said, oh, it's not difficult at all. She says, you have to go to a lot of parties and a lot of galas, and you can't possibly go if you have to work. And I said, well, and she said, she racked her mind, and she says, you know, I just remembered I accidentally dated someone once who worked.
Ooh, God forbid.
And she said, and we were going, and everything was going along nicely, and they'd gone to 4 or 5 events, and she reminded him that they had to attend something the next day, and he said, well, I can't possibly go because I have to work. And she said, I had no idea that you worked. He said, I'm afraid we're going to have to stop seeing one another. It's going to interfere.
Oh, my.
Well. So I thought that was... That's helpful to a person.
Yeah, that really is. But
to sort of weed them out.
That must be unbelievable wealth there.
It is. It is unbelievable wealth. It's
okay.
True.
We are going to come back and take a look at a few minutes of the movie. Yeah, from, what's the name of it?
All of Me.
All of Me with Steve Martin and Lily Tomlin right after this, folks. How did you like working with Steve Martin?
Oh, I loved it. I came to really feel a lot of affection for him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Had you not worked with him to a great extent before?
Very briefly on Saturday Night Live once.
Yeah, I've worked with him.
But we just sort of passed.
A few times, just like that. And he always strikes me as being a very reasonable, considerate human being.
Oh, he is. Yeah. Except he had this terrible habit. It actually wasn't a habit. It was sort of in his contract. But I wanted to do the part so much. And you know how a cat lover he is.
Yeah.
And he likes to entertain his cats. So he's got these two cats, Betty and Mary. And so he'd have them in his trailer, and he'd make me come in the trailer every day at lunchtime, and I'd have to open a can of cat food with my teeth. But I didn't mind, because the cats seemed to enjoy it so much.
Oh, Jesus, boy. God, what an ugly notion that is.
Did you think so?
Oh, well, with your teeth, I can understand one thing, with rubber gloves and proper sanitary conditions. Your teeth.
I'm sorry that I mentioned that. He probably wouldn't want that known. But I don't know why I don't mind.
All right, we have some footage here. Tell the folks what we're going to look at.
All right, this clip...
I'm sorry to interrupt you. I thought one of the funniest lines in the thing is when I think he says or you says, you say, let's give Big Ed some air.
Yeah, well, he ad-libbed that,
yeah,
naturally.
Yeah, that was very nice.
He was sort of self-aggrandizing, you know.
Uh-huh. All right, well, maybe that will be in the clip. You think so?
No, it's not that scene. That's an awfully cute scene.
All right.
As there are many of.
Yeah.
Anyway, this particular scene is not, actually, this is not one of the funny, really funny scenes, but it's a kind of setup scene, and, it shows how rich I am. I don't know why they're showing it. It's an awfully good scene.
It's a good scene.
I don't mean that, but it's like, it's not representative of when I'm inside his body and how funny that is.
Yeah.
This is when I'm still living and I'm outside his body. Uh-huh. He's my lawyer, and he comes to my home. And I've had him come to my house so that he can finish my will, so that I can leave all my money to the stableman's daughter, so that when I come back in my new body, I can get my old money.
Well, this is a good scene.
Yeah, so this is him coming over, and then he questions my sanity in this scene.
Yeah.
Because I tell him I'm going to come back from the dead.
Okay, this would be Lily Martin and Lily Martin.
That's about it.
And Steve Tomlin.
That's it.
A couple of new kids.
As your attorney, it is my duty to inform you that your will could be contested if you're deemed not of perfectly sound mind.
Why, you presumptuous ambulance chaser. Are you insinuating that I am not of perfectly sound mind?
No, I wouldn't do that, but I think practically everybody in the solar system would.
Mr. Cobb, the last thing I need around here is your ill-informed negativity. Get out.
Thanks for not inciting them.
Thank you, Steve.
Don't breathe. Don't breathe.
It's unnatural.
Terry.
No, Roger. Not yet. Roger, not yet.
There.
All right.
There.
I'm not ready.
Is everybody here bananas?
Let me explain something to you. You see, closer, please. That's for bananas. Now get out.
Yeah. Yeah. I believe this will probably do very well, don't you think so?
I do, sincerely.
Yeah,
it's quite funny. It's not quite funny. I think Steve's quite hilarious. The physical comedy is real, and it's motivated, you know, because of me being in his body and the struggle that goes on.
Yeah.
And all this, but it's also got a real sweetness to it, you know, and I don't know. I just like the combination.
Are you spending any time now creating new characters? Anything there?
Well, I'm working on a new show to bring back to New York, so I'm doing some stuff. Thanks. But I'm most excited because, I don't know what you want me to talk about.
Whatever you want to talk about.
Well, you know, I have to confess what I'm most excited about is that Ernestine got nominated for an Emmy this year.
Congratulations. Now,
and because Ernestine is really tired of working at the phone company, especially since the divestiture. And she's keeping her day job a little longer just until the offers start rolling in. But now since she broke, she break danced. What's the past tense of that?
I don't know.
She broke dunst?
What would that be, Paul? In broke dunst?
Break dunst.
Anyway, she did so well, you know, that she did get a nomination. And she's, I know that she asked Julio to take her to the Emmys.
Julio Iglesias?
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think I don't know if she's heard word back yet if he's going to or not. I know she does have a date after the Emmys with Warren Beatty.
No kidding.
Uh-huh.
All right. So these are
but
exciting
she does
days.
Get around. It is for Ernestine. It is exciting.
Yeah. Well, good luck with the film. Jeez, I really enjoyed having you here again, and I thought you were terrific in the
here.
Movie.
Thank you.
Hold it. Hey there. Right there. We got to pause for station identification. We'll be right back. Thank you. Thank you.